Welcome back, and thanks for tuning in to episode 31 of LabPadre, SpaceX, and Starbase weekly updates. As usual, we have a mound of details for you today, so let's dig in. Starting off this week, early Friday morning, Ship 24's aft flaps were folded in ahead of its removal from Test Stand B. Later that morning, with the sun now shining in the sky, SpaceX's LR-11000 lifted the ship from the test stand and placed it on the transport stand that had been staged nearby. Overnight Friday into Saturday, Falcon 9 booster B-1077 with integrated Crew Dragon Endurance were rolled to the pad ahead of the Crew 5 launch. Back at Starbase, a LOX pump and a methane pump were loaded onto flatbeds and driven away from the launch site. At Port Canaveral, SpaceX support ship Bob returned with the fairing halves from Starlink 4-35 launch after sheltering from the storm offshore. Over at Launch Complex 39A, Crew 5's ride to space was raised by the transport director as teams worked to prepare for launch. On Saturday, our friend and new photographer Nick D'Alessandro was at the shuttle landing facility at the Kennedy Space Center to catch the arrival of the Crew 5 astronauts. The four-person multinational crew touched down shortly after noon after spending time in pre-flight isolation in Houston. They paused for a brief photo opportunity on the landing strip before heading off to continue their preparations for their trip to the International Space Station. Back at Starbase, the saga of cryogenic pumps continued, with a blue-wrapped methane pump arriving at the launch site. Just a few hours later, the new pump was lifted and installed in methane pump slot number 3. A motor for the new pump followed that evening as crews worked to get the pump operational. Sunday morning, SpaceX's LR-11000 crane was relocated from suborbital pad B to over near the orbital launch mount. Back at Port Canaveral, one of SpaceX's fast boats was lowered from Bob into the water. A shortfall of gravitas was towed back into port with B-1073 from the Starlink 4-35 mission after sheltering near the Bahamas during the hurricane. A few hours later, the brand new Falcon 9 booster B-1077 was static fired on pad 39A in preparation for its upcoming launch. That evening, B-1073 was moved to the dock, freeing the drone ship to head out to sea for the next launch. Monday, our friends at Spaceflight Now caught the US and Crew 5 flags raised in front of B-1077. As the fairings were being offloaded from Bob, GatorCam caught one of them spinning freely while hanging from the crane. That afternoon, Bob left Port Canaveral in preparation for recovering the fairings from the upcoming Galaxy 33 and 34 launch. Back at Starbase, the methane subcoolers started to vent and frost up as some testing was done on that side of the arm. Tuesday morning, Ship 26's nose cone was lifted and stacked on its payload section on the turntable in High Bay. Down at the launch site, the motors were removed from the methane pump that was just installed a few days before. The pump soon followed in the motor's footsteps as it was removed and placed back on its pallet. That afternoon, a ULA Atlas V in the 531 configuration launched the SES-20 and SES-21 communication satellites on their way to the geosynchronous orbit from Space Launch Complex 41. On Tuesday evening, Rover 2CAM caught a tanker delivery from a trailer with a space-themed mural. Around the same time, the recently removed methane pump was loaded onto a trailer and driven away from the pad. Wednesday at noon, NASA and SpaceX's Crew 5 mission launched in SpaceX's seventh manned mission from Launch Complex 39A. Falcon 9 booster B-1077 successfully launched four NASA astronauts and carried them into an automated docking with the International Space Station the following day. At Starbase, the squid-like calibration equipment was again spotted being lifted and installed for additional testing following a week of upgrade work on the launch mount. Back at Port Canaveral, B-1073 was lifted and placed on the transporter for its move to SpaceX refurbishment facilities. Late on Wednesday night, the booster clamp, arms, and the orbital launch mount were seen retracting in what may have been a full-speed test. Thursday morning, two 2,000 kilowatt trailer mounted generators arrived at the launch site and were left near the electrical bunker. Around the same time, yet another new cryogenic pump was also delivered to the orbital tank farm. Just a few hours later, after it was delivered, the new pump was loaded onto another trailer and left the launch site. To finish off this week, early on Friday morning, Booster 7 was once again seen leaving Mega Bay. The booster was then rolled back down Highway 4 to the launch site following a more than 2 week stay in Mega Bay for what Elon referred to as robustness upgrades. These upgrades, however, did not seem to include the final pieces of shielding for the outer 20 Raptors, as they appear to be currently only covered by some kind of foil wrap. And there you have it, another SpaceX and Starbase weekly update brought to you by LabPadre. We'll see you next week, and thanks for watching. LabPadre out.